my beautiful astrology soulmates, and welcome to your weekly horoscope for the week of July 6th, where this week we are coming in hot off the press of a lunar eclipse that happened last week, marking our stamp for the next 6 months of ending things that have to do with power, authority, changing things in the career and the home zone. We've already seen them. We're going to go back over them and start to bring some things to culmination over this next 6 months, and we definitely see that influence this week in the energies as well. Now, before we jump in and I tell you about what's happening in the cosmos this week on the Eat and Greets, we have just, it is just fire this week. It is just so much goodness. On Tuesday, we have not only Colin Bedell starting us out in the morning at 9 a.m. Mountain Time with relationship talk. We're going to talk about relational houses, houses 4 through 8. What's the impact that those have on our lives? So grab your chart, grab a little snack, and come over and eat and greet with us. And then that afternoon at 4 p.m., Christopher Rindstrom, Gary Caton, and myself are going to talk about the astrology of China, and I cannot wait to lay this out. We've got charts and everything to lay this out for you guys so we can see what's happening 2020 and going forward, because what's happening there does have some impact here in the United States for sure, so you're not going to want to miss any of that. On Wednesday, we have our reschedule of Tony Howard, who's going to come talk about Out of Bounds Planet, and we're going to end the week with Tammy Brooke coming to talk about astrology and dreams. I mean, it is fire around here this week, so don't miss out on the Eat and Greets, okay? All right, let's get into what's happening in the cosmos. Right at the beginning of the week, we come in with the moon in the energy of Aquarius. It's sitting nice. There's good things happening with both Venus and Mars. And this is right here at the beginning of the week with this moon here in Aquarius. One of the things I continue to sense, especially after this full moon, after Saturn has moved back into Capricorn out of the energy of Aquarius, one of the things I just keep thinking is this is freedom. We are looking for freedom. We are looking for the freedom of our own individuality. On global levels, we are looking towards freedom. But this is information that is coming to us with a fair amount of ease because Mars and Venus are both direct at this point. So we have a little bit of access to information, and it's like freedom through information is kind of what shows up here. And maybe this is even conversations with groups or friends, but these are the kind of conversations where you're getting deeper, you're getting to the heart of things, you're trying to see things in a more innovative, ingenious, future-minded kind of way. So enjoy the stir of the information that is going to lead to freedom as we kick off here on Monday. Now, I will tell you, we get this information as we start the week out, right? And right off of this full moon lunar eclipse. But we get to Tuesday and we're under some void of course. And void of course means it's time to hold. It's time to pause based on your own journaling and your own experience. A void, of course, may be a time where you are happily finishing up projects or something like that. But ultimately, we don't want to start new projects, and we find it hard to move them forward under a void, of course, because it's just like there's a little block that happens there. Now, it doesn't ease up when we get to Wednesday because we see Mercury, who's still in retrograde at this point, even though he's coming out of retrograde at the end of the week. At this point on Wednesday, he's not out of retrograde and he is squaring up to Mars, okay? Now, Mercury, who's of the mind, Mars, who's over there in the action, the energy, the movement, and definitely in the mouth right now, are in square and in tension to each other. So one of the things that's happening, I think, as Mercury is still retrograde in this energy of Cancer, what happens is these are emotions. We're emotionally vulnerable. There are emotionally vulnerable topics and conversations. Plus, being in Mercury retrograde, this could be things that are coming up from the past and we are readdressing them and having these conversations. So this could definitely be an energy with Mercury and Mars in square here where we've got this freedom of information we're trying to put down, but we're finding it hard to have the conversations and have them come out clear enough for us to actually move forward. It's really like you take one step forward and like five back is kind of what the energy hits. So here is not a great day to sign those new contracts, make those big decisions if you can avoid them. I really do think that even if you are trying to make travel plans or send a simple message for the next couple days, just know that the square energy here has kind of complicated things a little bit. Now, where is this good? This is good because if things need to be said, if things need to be looked at aggressively from the past, we're going to do that. for some people and for some places in the world, these are going to be angry outbursts, right? People are not taking it to the integrity level. There's a place of blame and shame and hurt or something or truth that comes up, and there could be this sense of anger. So I would also tell you to keep in mind, because we're in a Mercury retrograde, try and have some grace with your fellows. Doesn't mean be a doormat, but it means remember, people's struggles are on the surface right now, yours, mine, and everyone else included. And so we're trying to find the best way forward to handle those. Now, when we get to Friday, we see the moon traveling through the energy of Pisces. And I actually like this vibe, although it does heighten the vibe. But the moon in Pisces starts to kind of drop us down to a different level, and there's a little bit more compassion, there's a little bit more empathy that happens on the table. Not to mention, this moon is particularly good with Jupiter and Pluto. Now, it's great because Jupiter is a traditional ruler of Pisces, so this is quite comfortable in that dance. But at the same time, they are in retrograde. They are still traveling together, Jupiter and Pluto. So this place where we're just all full-scale compassionate, I don't know that we exactly have that, but I think it makes it easier in that energy. So if you do have to go back to something with power, authority, work, even people who've been in positions of authority in your life, and you're looking back over those things, shoot for the place of compassion. Shoot for the place of forgiveness. Shoot for that place of transition to move past whatever needs to be moved past here. But I also think if you are creative, this is a wonderful energy for you at the end of the week to go back to see how you can take that creative thing, put some structure to it, put some value to it, and bring it forward. Now, as we get to the 11th, which is Saturday, we see Chiron, our wounded healer, stepping into retrograde until December. Now, we're going to go back over the deep wound, the deep hurt that we've seen come up. This is globally. This is personally. This is the space that we're all going to go back to. But this is the thing. Because Chiron, as an asteroid, moves relatively slow, it's not speeding around there, I don't know that it's like, wham, bam, thank you, ma'am, you feel it today. This could be something that unfolds slowly over time. What I do think speeds this up this day is that the moon, Mars, Chiron, they're all there conjuncting in this energy of Aries as Chiron's taking this retrograde. So truly, it is really this question, I think, that Brian Coulter talks a lot about aggressively healing. We are being aggressive. We are being assertive about going back to where the wound is at for us. With Chiron retrograde in Aries, this is that question of, where are you not accepting yourself for who and what you are? Where have you held yourself back from being who and what you really are? Where's the wound of your identity? And every single one of us has been stepping into looking at it. Our world is changing. How do we fit into it again right now? So this is the energy this day that speaks to me about this aggressive healing that is available for our evolution. Now, when we get to Sunday, we see Mercury coming out of retrograde, coming direct, which means conversations, communications, all of these things can get back on track, maybe be moving a little bit more steadily, travel plans open up a little bit more, but definitely conversation of the heart, conversation that is emotionally intelligent, conversation that can consider the vulnerabilities of others, conversation that is about our homes, our securities. This comes back online in a very forward motion kind of way. Now, as the sun, or as Mercury comes direct, we also see him making a really beautiful trine to Neptune, who's retrograde. And I really think that this is one of the most useful energies of the week. Because now, not only is conversation, decision making, sending messages, receiving messages more in a forward motion, but it's this place where it really is, there's forgiveness, there's empathy, there is the aggressive healing on the table, but what we're doing is we're doing it together, we're not doing it separately, right? It's this energy where it's like, this trine softens some of the conversation, softens some of the energy that happens this week. So I think if you get to the end of the week and you're feeling like things have been a little bit tense, this energy does come in to create a little bit of a softness here. Now, it's also really nice because it is great for the imagination, which means as you're making deals, as you're negotiating, as you're having conversations, you may find yourself walking into some really good deals or some really good circumstances that you are just wrapped in something that almost seems too good to be true. And in this particular trine, if it seems too good to be true, just do your research, but it might not be. It might just be your lucky day. All right, you guys, I think it's going to be a good week up in the cosmos. I hope you use it well. I hope you step out this week, especially with all of this Neptunian energy available to us, and be of service to other people. Be a secret angel to someone this week. You never know what you could be doing to just leave a little smile for somebody who really, really needs it, and it'll warm your heart as well. So like this video, comment, share, subscribe, enjoy the journey through the cosmos this week. I will see you in the eat and greets, and the eat and greets are not stopping anytime soon. There's lots of goodness coming your way, so I hope to see you connecting in. I love you guys, and I'll see you next week. Bye.